3 of these goals. That is my number one financial goal, my number one family goal, my number one career goal. Can you write one goal? The most important goal. Only the top line. The next one I will discuss it with you, but the top line only you write. One financial goal, one family goal, one career goal. What can be family goal, tell me? What are the kind of family goals you can think of?
To build a house.
Very good. Very good. That's a good goal, family goal.
Peace in the family.
Huh? Peace in the family. How peace in the family? How can you bring in peace in the family? Now you have to be very, you know, it's a good, very interesting goal, but how exactly you would do? By spending quality time with your wife and children. Isn't it? Say, I will spend 2 hours every day with my family. Or an hour with my family. Or you can say, I will go for a walk with my wife for an hour. Or I will take my family for a picnic every week once. I mean, these are all the goals which you can achieve. Very specifically, yes. Then you see the peace and joy and the togetherness in the family coming in. Actually, time is premium. You are all working, professionals. We don't have time for a family. So it's become very important that we set goals for a family. We are accountable to our family. Isn't it? So write such goals for your family. You cannot write, I love my wife, I love my husband. That's not a goal at all. How will you love your wife? How will you love your husband? You have to be very specific. How will you love? I will compliment her every time she does something good. That's one way of showing her love. Isn't it? Be specific about how you're going to express a love to your spouse. I don't know, you should be knowing all that. I'm just giving you examples, what kind of goals. Friends, they might look very silly and simple, but this is what makes life meaningful. Simple things only make life meaningful. Giving compliments. Appreciating. Okay? Positive gestures. Positive stroke. This is what makes your family life happy and joyful. Not big things. You buy a big mansion and keep criticizing your wife, your wife will not like it at all. Okay? Talk to her kindly. Talk to her nicely. Same husband also. Wife also should know how to reciprocate his love. Then you see the togetherness, happiness in the family. These are the small things but make a big difference in family life. Small things make a big impact in family life. Write such goals. You must surprise your spouse by writing some goals. Wow, what a goal your husband should say. Look at your wife's goal. The wife should, what a fantastic goal you got for your family life. Surprise your spouse. These things only matter. Family goal. Career goal. Now let's see. Analyze one goal. Huh? Under that goal you have desire. 1 to 10 scale. Belief 1 to 10 scale. There are two things. First is, what is the desire for your goal? Suppose you written a financial goal or family goal. What is the desire in the scale of 1 to 10? How would you grade? Can one of you help me with one of your family goals? Anybody has written any family goal here? Yes, tell me.
Spend some time with my children.
To spend some time. It's not some time, can be 1 minute or it can be 2 hours. Which is the time?
At least solid half an hour with my children.
Solid half an hour with children.
Just playing with them.
Excellent.
Just letting them know that I care for them.
Excellent. Have you not been doing this all this time? Look at that. It needed an SRM meeting for a person to realize. Amazing. This is all God speaking to you. This is exactly what God brought you here. To tell you, your children need you. You need to go half an hour. This is a big step you are taking today. Big step. Everybody's life, there is something was lacking. God is speaking to you today. Set it as a goal for yourself. God is here to fulfill that goal for you. He is with you. You are not alone. You will find it difficult, but God will make it easy for you to achieve. Half an hour, okay? I will give half an hour to my children every day. Now, what is the desire in the scale of 1 to 10? Where would you rate that?
1 being what?
Lowest. 10 being highest. they say for that goal is highest or lowest or somewhere in between?
Highest.
10. 10. Very good. So you write 10 here. Okay? Then what is the belief? Do you think you will achieve it? Every day, half an hour? Throughout my life, hereafter?
Belief is somewhere in 6, 7.
Somewhere 6? Okay. Somewhere midway through. Now look at that. You know why your desire is 10? Because the reward is very high. You know the reward is going to be? When the reward is high, your desire for the goal will also be very high. You will be very passionate. You understand that? Here the belief is somewhere in between. You know why? You have some fear about it. I may be able to give, I may not be able to give because I am working. You are working? Yes. Not all the days, maybe 2 days in a week. Because you are very confused about it. The fear is there, the lurking fear. So now, what you must do is, you must convert this fear into reward. Or you can say, okay, I will just put it this way. When a reward is high, you know, there is one force operating. When a fear is high, another force is operating. You know why? There are two kinds of power. One is called willpower, other one is called wish power. One is called willpower, other one is called wish power. Willpower is putting heart and mind and soul and everything. That's called willpower. You know what is wish power? You only want it, but you don't want to work for it. That's called wish power. Proverbs 21:25. One of you read that. Proverbs 21:25th verse. What does it say? It talks about wish power there. Proverbs 21:25.
The sluggard's craving will be the death of
the sluggard is the lazy guy. Okay, the lazy man.
Craving will be the death of him because his hands refuse to work.
The lazy man craves for a lot of things, but his hands refuse to work. Ultimately, the craving will kill him. That's what it says. So that is called wish power. You want everything, but you don't want to work for it. So in our life, there are two kinds of power can operate. One is willpower, other one is wish power. When your fear is more, what is operating? Your wish power is operating. When your reward is more, what is the power will be operating? Your willpower operating. You understand that? Now, both have to be willpower. Only then you can achieve the goal. So you have to convert your wish power into willpower. That's the secret of achieving your goal. Convert your wish power into willpower. How do you convert your wish power into willpower?
Working.
By?
Working
towards it. How to convert your wish power into willpower?
When you get the confidence,
increase the confidence, increase the commitment. Check for your value. What is the value? Do you have that value for the goal? If you have the corresponding value, connect the goal with the value with the proper plan and action. Then your wish power will be converted into willpower. See, it's easy to say but difficult to practice it. But then take one goal at a time. Try to look at what is the scale in desire, what is scale belief, what's the reward and fear. If the reward is more, willpower is operating. If fear is more, wish power is operating. Then how to convert it? By connecting your value to the goal with the proper plan and action. Increase your commitment. Increase your commitment to that. You think that you need to be accountable to your children. You are called to be a person of accountability. Practice one by one, you will see you will be able to achieve your goal. It's a bit difficult exercise initially, but slowly if you start doing it, you will be achieving goals after goals. Goals after goals, you will come to pass in it. You will experience joy of being very successful. Okay. Same way, you can also write other goals, personal goals, spiritual goal, intellectual goal, and then you can analyze it. I've taken just one for example. Okay. Now, we need to think our goal through. When we write a goal, these are things you have to think through. One is, what are the skills do I need to achieve this? You have written one goal, no? I will spend half an hour mentioning. What are the skills you need there?
Patience.
Huh? Patience, yes. Patience. Write down here. Patience is the skill I need. Okay? Second, what information knowledge do I need? write down. It may not fit in this goal, but other goal. What information, knowledge do I need? What my children like the most? What kind of game they need, isn't it? Okay? That information you need to get that. You write it down. What help and collaboration do I need? Do you need somebody else's help? Who can help you out?
My spouse.
Your spouse, yes. Some collaborator you must find out. Someone who can help you. And then what resources do I need? Find right on the resources. What can block my progress in achieving? What is that can prove to be an obstacle? Write it down. Am I making any assumption? Is this goal a simple assumption or realistic? Is there any better way of doing this? If you ask all these questions for a goal yourself, for yourself, find an answer, your goal, you would have thought through your goal. To a great extent, you would have set yourself in achieving that goal. This is what's called thinking a goal through. Friends, life is not very simple as we think. We need to really get down to the nitty-gritty. Think clearly, step-wise, set goals, then you enjoy your life. Otherwise, you are just taking life very casually. Another thing is, any goal set casually, taken lightly, any goal set casually, taken lightly, will be freely abandoned at the very first obstacle. I repeat the statement. Any goal set casually, taken lightly, will be freely abandoned at the very first obstacle. So don't set your goals casually and don't take them very lightly. These are too important. Then only you'll be able to achieve your goal. This is just exhorting. Noah had a goal, it was an ark. Nehemiah had a goal, it was a wall. Moses had a goal, it was the liberation of God's people. Paul the Apostle had a goal, it was to reach the Gentiles. Jesus had a goal to save us. You have a goal, what is your goal? You know, I'm talking about your life goal. I'm not talking about day-to-day. See, we have many different goals. Short-term goals, long-term goals, and life goal. God has brought us into this world with one important purpose in His mind. God has a purpose for our life. A unique purpose. Everybody is not given the same purpose. God has a unique purpose. That becomes your life goal. How many of you know your life goal? This is what God has called me for. How many of you know for sure? Yes, brother, one hand has gone up. You must be damn sure about it. This is exactly what God has called me to. Friends, I understand most of us do not know that. We are wasting our time. When you don't know your life goal, you'll waste your time, you'll waste your resources, you'll misuse your relationships, because we do not know what we are here for. There's a crying need for each one of us to know, what is my life goal? Why is that God has put me on this earth? Otherwise, we are simply wasting all our time. All of our comfort and position, degrees, family, everything is waste. If you do not know what is your life goal, I'm going to help you today. God's purpose for me coming here is to help this group to find out their individual life goal. I feel that God has brought me mainly for this because He wants to speak to you. It's not my desire. Why? Because, look at this. It is finished. Who said this? Jesus said. Where? On the cross. On the cross. You know, why did God create all of this? Do you know? Isaiah 43:7 says, God created us all to glorify Him. What is that? To glorify. That's the reason why He created. I mean, one of the two or three reasons. How does one glorify God, tell me? How do you glorify God?
By doing His will.
By doing His will. By doing His will. John 17:4 says, Jesus says, how we glorify God. He says, Father, I have brought glory to you on this earth by completing the work that you gave me to do. What is that? Father, I brought glory to you on this earth by completing the work that you gave me to do. In John 17, 4th verse. That means we can glorify God not through good intentions, not merely by singing. We think by singing God, God is glorious. Yes, true. But actually, ultimately, you can glorify God only through the work that He gave you to do. Simple, as simple as that. Are you doing what God wants you to do? Ask yourself. Then you can say it is finished. It's believed. At the end of the life, the whole person can say two things. I'm happy, I finished. Huh? I'm happy, I finished. Or you can say, wish I had more time. Wish I had? Which group are you going to belong to? Are you going to say it is finished? Or wish I had more time, I could have done something more for God. Second is, Paul says, I have fought a good fight. I finished the race. I have kept the faith. Finally, these are the people who finished well in life. A goal setter is the one who finishes well in life. Good beginning is not enough. Good finish is very important. What is that? You need to begin well, but what is more important? You need to finish well. If you don't finish well, the world will forget you. Everybody will forget you. Only those who finish well are remembered forever. Are you going to be a good finisher? It doesn't matter where you come from, but what matters where you are going to end up. Isn't it? It's not matter whether you are born in a big family or small family, Gulf countries or India. All this don't matter. What matters is where you are going to go. That is what. So finishing is more important than beginning. Some of us might have said, I have begun well. But are you also going to finish well? A goal setter is the one who begins well and then also finishes well in life. This is a very important thing I am trying to talk to you. When you try to find a life goal, there are two important questions you need to ask yourself. I said I will help you to find out your life goal. Number one question is, who am I? If somebody would ask, who are you, what will you say, sir?
Huh? I will tell my name.
Your name then? That's all you tell your name and leave that? I am so and so, I am here, I am doing this, isn't it?
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
That's one identity, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, what is the true identity? I believe, once in Bangalore airport, there was some flight delay. Lot of people are stranded. So, a lot of flights not taking off. So people are standing in queue. Suddenly, one flight was announced going to Delhi. So, all those who wanted to go to Delhi stood in a queue. Long queue was there. So, the reception was clearing one by one. Suddenly, one fellow jumped the queue and came to her. Just put the ticket. Please put me in the next flight immediately. She looked at me. Sir, you have to wait in the queue and then only. Yes. Do you know who I am? He asked the question. Do you know who I am? Obviously, he was a big politician. For instance, the reception took the phone and said, ladies and gentlemen, here is a man who does not know who he is. Will you please help him to find out who he is? Very often, we put on our wrong identity. I'm so-and-so, doing this, doing that, I'm a big officer, I'm a manager, all that we say. But what is the real identity? Bible says, you are a chosen people, you are a royal priesthood, you are a holy nation, a people belonging to God. You are children of God, you are friends of God, ambassadors of Christ. These are our true identity. Do you ever think about it? If somebody would ask you, who are you? I'm a friend of God. Do you ever say that? That's the last thing to come to our mind, isn't it? I'm a child of God, do you say that? That's the last thing to come to our mind. I'm an ambassador of Christ, do you say that? No, that's the last thing to come to our mind. The true identity is what Bible gives us. If you know your true identity, you will go for the right goals, okay? Very often we are following after goals for which we are not created. We are not designed for. This is the first. The second one is, what is the purpose of my life? Once you know what's the true identity, second is, what is the purpose of my life? Bible says, Proverbs 9, many are the plans in a man's heart, but it